Hey everyone, Clara here with a quick tip on archiving pages. So, you might be doing lots of explorations in your files and find that you don't really need to reference that older work anymore. Let's say you're ready to archive some of that work. I'm going to gather all of the frames I don't need anymore and put them on their own page. I'll name the page Archive along with the date. Before we save it to version history, I want to show a few ways to access the version history of your file. If you go to the very left menu, there's an option under File to both save to version history or to view it. Another entry point is near the title of the file at the top. There you can see the version history, and once that comes up, there's a plus icon to the very right to let you add to it. If you're a shortcuts person, you can directly add to version history using Command Option S on Mac or Control Option S on Windows. And lastly, if you want to use the quick actions bar instead, and not worry about memorizing all the shortcuts, open that quick actions bar using Command forward slash on Mac or Control forward slash on Windows. Once this is open, you can type in the action you want to take. In this case, we want to save to version history. Again, I'm going to name this archive along with the date. I'm also going to include a short description of what I archived and click save. At this point, we now have a hard save. So what I'm going to do is delete the page. I know this may seem scary, but I promise the archived page is still there. When we go to version history again, we can see the logged change. When I click into it, the page we deleted is back. You'll notice when we're viewing these previous versions, you can't click into anything. If you find you want to bring back an editable frame, you have the option to duplicate the file at that specific point in the version history. Now, you could imagine this version history can get quite long. If you don't want that archive state buried in the version history, you can always surface it as a link on the cover page or an info page. Going back to that same menu where we duplicated the file, you can copy that link. So I'm going to copy that link and bring it over to my cover page where I have a few other links. Now my team and any viewers of the file have quick access to those archived portions. That wraps up this tip. I hope this helps keep your files clean and speedy. See you next time.